guys, Ashley here for another special little Disney collection video. This time we're going to be taking a deep dive into our kitchen cabinet and showing you our Disney mug collection. I have to do a little bit of a disclaimer. I don't drink coffee anymore and I hardly drink tea, so these mugs are virtually going unused. Sometimes they're used for tea, sometimes they're used for like hot chocolate, but I found myself collecting these mugs. I find that they're a really good souvenir and they're very like inexpensive sometimes. I do want to mention before we start the video, I'm gonna open up this cabinet and you guys are going to see like an unedited what my cabinet and all of the mugs look like right now at their current state. It's definitely not gonna be organized, I know that, but just like the bag video, I do want to at the very end kind of organize and make everything look really like nice and clean. So I'm killing two birds with one stone. I'm showing you guys my collection and also like organizing and cleaning it up. So without further ado, I'll stop chitter chatter and let's get into my Disney mug collection. Here is a brief little overview of our countertop. So we have these Funko Pop tin cans that we got at the Funko store in Hollywood. We store like different teas and hot chocolates in here and like some lemonade. So the first one being like our little lemonade sachets. And then this one has like some sugar and some chai tea in it. And then the last one has like some sleepy nighttime tea. Here is the cabinet where we have all of our mugs. Again, this is what we're working with. It is not organized by any means, but by the end of this video, it will be, that's for sure. Here we have the first mug. It says, my Disney princess name is Taco Bell. This is one of my favorites, not only because you know I love Disney, I love princesses, but I love Taco Bell. I love a good meal from Taco Bell, but also my last name is Bell. So it's just like, it's such a cute mug. I was gifted this from a friend and she purchased this on Etsy. Mug number two is this adorable little Gus Gus mug I got on Shop Disney. It is super cute and I love how inside it says Zoot Zoot. I use this quite a bit. I like how it's a little bit taller. Here is another Cinderella mug. We have Cinderella on the front looking fabulous with the little birdies. But on the back, we have Gus Gus and it says Cinderella's Shoe Shop. I mean, he is just so cute. Another one of my faves just because it has Gus Gus on it. Here is a mug that's not necessarily Disney, but gives me Disney Minnie Mouse vibes. This is a Kate Spade Linux mug that I was gifted, I believe, 7-8 years ago, maybe even longer, for like a birthday, and I've kept it ever since just because, again, it gives me Minnie Mouse vibes. I really love it and it's really expensive and definitely my most bougie mug. Another non-Disney mug, but if you know me, I love Friends. Like, that show is definitely my favorite like sitcom show of all time. So on the front it says Central Perk and on the back it says Friends. I was gifted this as well and I really like this one a lot. I usually end up drinking tea out of this one the most. Here we have a little Mickey and Minnie Christmas thermos that Chris got in the Disney Funko mystery treasure boxes. It's really cute. We love taking this to the parks if we want like really, really hot tea or if we're out and about like walking around and it's really cold. This mug instantly made me think of Chris and I. So on the front, it has Minnie and Mickey with their tail making a little heart. And it says, my happy place is with you during the fireworks. You guys know fireworks is like our time, we call it. And we always give like a good kiss and a hug or a nice embrace during the firework time, which is 9:30 normally here in Anaheim. And it holds a very special meaning to us. So that's why I picked this one up. I am now going to show you my Starbucks You Are Here collection Disney Parks edition. I do have quite a few of these. I have collected these for a couple years now, but I do not have all of them. The first one being the Disneyland mug. This is my favorite, or like one of my favorites from the specific like Disney Parks collection. And it says Disneyland with the Matterhorn. We have the castle and then the train and then Small World with the fireworks. I really love this one. And then the inside is like a pretty, pretty blue color. I love the colors, the pink and the blue and like that like burgundy fuchsia-y kind of color. Definitely one of my favorite ones. Here we have like my second favorite mug from the You Are Here collection. So it says Disneyland. This is predominantly supposed to like indicate and show Fantasyland. So we have the Peter Pan ride right here and then the carousel, teacups, we have the castle in the back, we have some of the cottages, the storybook ride, it's a Small World, and then the Matterhorn in the back. But I just think this one with the colors and stuff is just so cute. I am a sucker for like that pink and purple and blue look. It's so cute. And then the inside we have like a muted purple. Here we have the California Adventure mug. So we have the Grizzly Bear, we have the Radiator Racers or Radiator Springs ride, and then we have a little trolley with the Ferris wheel in the back, and then Carthay Circle. This one is also very cute, and the inside it's red. Here we have another Disneyland mug. This one is focusing on New Orleans. So we have the Haunted Mansion, and then it quickly transitions into the Pirates of the Caribbean, which I really think is cute, especially if you love either of these rides or you are a particular fan of New Orleans Square. And then the inside is like this really dark purple. Here we have another Disneyland one. This one is focusing on Adventureland. So as you can see, we have like the Tiki Room kind of decorative aesthetic with the two little birds. And then we have the Hippo, which transitions into the Jungle Cruise. And that is the front side of Water Folks. But this one is really cute. I like this one as well. And then the inside is this like really pretty green color. The next mug is a Disney Animal Kingdom mug. When I went to Florida, I purchased this. So we have Expedition Everest here, the ride. That one is so awesome. I don't know what ride this is because we weren't able to go on it. I think it was closed when we went, but I had to get it. I mean, it went with my collection, and we did go to Animal Kingdom, so it's really cute. And then inside is like an orange color. Next mug is Disney's Hollywood Studios mug. I also got this when we went to Florida. So they have the little green men here, and then they have the entrance on the right hand side. It moves over to Tower of Terror, and then I believe this is Aerosmith's Rock and Roller Coaster. That ride is crazy. And then it just has some other little artwork on the sides here as well. I really enjoyed Hollywood Studios when we got to go. I can't wait to go again. Sadly, I didn't get the other two parks, so I don't have Magic Kingdom and Epcot. The lines for the Starbucks were so long that day, so I ended up not getting those, but I do have these two. Now, I know this one isn't Disney, but it is a part of the You Are Here collection from Starbucks. It is Japan. When I went to Japan in 2018 with Chris, they didn't have one, like they don't have like a special mug at Disneyland for Japan. So I wanted to get this one just to kind of like commemorate our travel there. But I really like the colors and like the artwork and stuff like that. I think it's really pretty and cute. And in the inside, it has a red lining. Starbucks eventually discontinued the You Are Here collection and then started the Been There series. So this is the Disneyland version of the Been There series. It says the wildest ride in the wilderness with like Thunder Mountain. We have like carousel. We have like the storybook ride. Mint Julep has cute little like Mickey icons everywhere. We have the castle. We have the dog from Pirates of the Caribbean, Mr. Toad's ride, the monorail, like Hatbox Ghost, the canoes, Matterhorn, Mickey Waffles, Space Mountain, and then it says the happiest place on earth, like the Alice in Wonderland ride, like the Tiki Room. It just has really, really, really cute artwork. Again, I probably said this 1,000 times already, but this is like honestly one of my favorite ones. I love the pink inside, and I just love looking at all the cute little like artwork. Here we have a Star Wars themed mug. So on the front it says I love you, and then on the back it says I know. And I actually have two of these, so Chris and I can sip these together. This mug was gifted to us by a follower, and it has Mickey Mouse written right there. And then it has a film strip with just different Mickeys doing different dances and expressions and what have you. This one's really cute. To go with that mug, we have another one with Mickey, and he's like half steamboat, half regular Mickey, and it says the true original with a bunch of little Mickeys on it again. These are super cute. I like how they're clear. It just gives me more of like a bougie vibe, but I really like these for like hot chocolate. Here we have a different mug. It's more of a cup of sorts, a souvenir cup, but we have Andy's boot from Toy Story. We got this at Disneyland. What I really like is on the bottom of the foot, it says Andy. This is my favorite Halloween mug. I really like how it's like Mickey, but in ghost form with the little tail. I think it's really cute, but the back, it says boo to you. Isn't it? Oh, it's so adorable. I love drinking hot chocolates out of this during the Halloween. It's really cold. Here we have another Halloween mug. This one's actually really cute too. I like how his handle is supposed to be like his ear, but it is Mickey as a vampire. Okay, I lied. I think this one is my favorite Halloween mug. This is a Nightmare Before Christmas mug. So this is the mayor. This is like when he's like super happy, kind of nutsy, crazy, kooky. And then on the other side, it's the mayor, but when he's like distressed, sad, I don't know, agony type of look. What I like most about this mug is the silicone top hat. So the mayor wears like a really tall, tall top hat in the film, but this one obviously is a little bit shorter, but still really cute. And you're able to take it off and like put your liquids or what have you inside, and then put the lid back on to keep it extra warm. Speaking of holidays, this by far is my favorite like holiday cute adorable outlandish mug I own. So we have the bottom, which is Mickey with a little handle, and then on the top we have the whipped cream with green and red Mickey sprinkles and then a little holly. What's really cute is you can lift the top off and then you can put your little hot chocolate inside, and if you want it to keep really warm, you can just keep it closed. Don't know if you're really gonna be able to see this mug because it's white and our background is white, but this is a Club 33 mug that I got when we visited Club 33. This was like my souvenir along with the ears. It's a very like nice porcelain color with like white inside. And then on the bottom it says Club 33 established 1967 with the price. So it was 25 bucks. Here we have a Walt Disney World like vintage glass cup that we were gifted. So this is supposed to be Disney Studios and it has just like different artwork of Disney Studios. I really like it. And then you can see an angle on the bottom, it says Disney World. Isn't that so cute? Here is another vintage Disney cup. So it has like a bunch of like just different characters and different sayings. I just really like it. I love how Steamboat is so big. But if you look at this one, this is a McDonald's cup. I just think these are so cool. I don't remember these at all. So it's nice to see something being like, wow, like this was available. Like this is awesome. We're gonna move over to our Trader Sam's like mug slash cup edition. So this one is a zombie head. This one is specifically the second edition Trader Sam's Enchanted Tiki Bar. So I know they have different editions of each item. So this one in particular is the second edition. This guy we got when we went to Walt Disney World at Trader Sam's. On the back it says Trader Sam's Grog Grotto. This was like Chris's souvenir that he brought home. It came with a beverage inside, which was mighty tasty. Here we have another Trader Sam's cup. So this one has all of the different characters from Haunted Mansion, and it's a glossy finish with a cream and green background. But that's where the inside of the cup is. So I know these were like very like sought after. We do have a couple of these. It doesn't say the edition on here, but this is one of Chris's favorites. Here we have the same mug, but just a little bit different. It has all of the characters from Haunted Mansion. This is a matte finish with a black and cream color to it. Here we have a Hatbox Ghost cup. So this one has a matte and shiny finish, but we have the Hatbox Ghost head in the actual like hat box, and he has like no face up on here. This one is from Florida, so let me go ahead and flip around and show you. Here on the bottom it says first edition Trader Sam's Grog Grotto Disney, and then this is a little like thing I wanted to show you. It says Memento Mori 1702, I believe. And we traded with a friend to get this one because we weren't in Florida when this came out. Here is what the Disneyland California mug looks like for Hatbox Ghost. So his face is actually on his body. It's not like floating over here in the box. This is a matte finish with a dark brown and cream coloring. And let me go ahead and show you the bottom. So on the bottom, it says first edition Trader Sam's Enchanted Tiki Bar. And then also on the side, this says a Memento Mori 1702. Here we have another piranha mug from Trader Sam's. This one is very scary. Look at that. And on the bottom it says it's the first edition Trader Sam's Enchanted Tiki Bar. I believe this came with a drink called the Piranha, but I could be wrong. Maybe like the Piranha Pool. Chris really likes to collect these, so this is another one of his favorites. While we're on the tiki train, this is a Club 33 cup that I purchased when we went to the club during like their tiki celebration. I think this is super cute and I have yet to use it because I'm too scared. I don't want to ruin it. Here is the mug that sold out like crazy all the time at the parks. It flew off the shelves. It is the Coco Jarrito. This is the first version. So it says Disney Pixar Coco on the front with the little movie logo. And then on the back, it says Recuérdame, Remember Me. And it has like Miguel with his Dia de los Muertos, like Sugar School, like makeup going on. I know they brought back another one this past year. I didn't pick that one up, but I do love and use this one quite a bit. I know this isn't a mug, but it is a tumbler, and it's honestly my favorite tumbler I own. It is a Mickey Mouse tumbler. This was a part of the Mickey's 90th and like Target collaboration. We have a little orange top with Mickey, a teal little straw, and then some rainbow different Mickey heads all over. I only use it like during the summer because I'm like, I don't want to ruin it. I don't want to break it. It is plastic, but still I'm just like super careful because this is like really cute. The next item is another sipper. This is Chris's. I don't remember the exact name of the animal, but I know this is from Galaxy Galaxy's Edge, and it is the animal that produces the green and blue milk. He's used it a couple times, but the light really runs out really quick on this. I don't know if it's the battery or if it's supposed to run out really quickly, but I don't think he's used it recently just because the battery died so quickly. Here is a coffee cup that we got at Walt Disney World. So it says Walt Disney World on here, and it has the gang driving up into the parks. We got this as a drink tumbler where you're able to pay like a certain amount and then you get like unlimited refills. There's like a chip inside or what have you. We were all up for free refills. Aulani does the exact same thing as Florida, so they offer tumblers or coffee mugs for like one baseline price, and then you're able to get unlimited refills throughout your stay. This one was fairly inexpensive. I think it was like 20 bucks, and throughout your entire stay you get free refills. Chris and I just shared a cup to like, you know, lower costs, but this one was really cute. Here we have another Disney vintage cup. It's super cute. I believe this is from Epcot by what it looks like, but it has First for Mickey on it. It was a gift, and then on the sides, I don't know if you can see, but it says Walt Disney World on the bottom. 2000. Wow, this is 20 years old. We have two of these cups. These were a gift from our friend. It says a USA on the front, and then it has Minnie and Mickey already for 4th of July. They're like little plastic cups. We like using these for like lemonade. We use these. This isn't a mug, but it's another glass. So this is like a Mickey glass, and on the back it says Mickey. I also have a mini one to go with that. So it has Minnie on the front and then Minnie on the back. Here we have, I'm scared to say, a shot glass. I mean, look at the size of my hand. It's huge. It has the Sorcerer Mickey hat on there, and then on the side it says Disney MGM Studios. I don't think myself or Chris would want to take a shot of just this. I don't know. This is dangerous. Lastly, I wanted to show you guys these little stacks of like plastic cups. I use them for like ice cream or any snacks. My mom got these from Kohl's when they were on clearance, but I just thought that they were really cute and worth showing you guys. Here we have our entire mug collection. I have some here. I needed a chair to reach like the ones way up there. I have some other mugs here as well that aren't Disney, but for the majority, these are like our little mug Disney babies and cups as well. I think now it's time for me to get to cleaning and organizing and showing you guys what it looks like when I'm all done. All right, I have now organized. So the bottom shelf has like our shot glasses, the little cups I showed you, all of like the clear style like drinking cups, along with like some non-Disney-ish mugs. And then on this one, I have like the clear vintage cups in the front, and then all of the Starbucks You Are Here / Been There series mugs here, and then all of like the Halloween mugs are back here. And then on the third shelf we have all of like the tiki style Trader Sam's mugs. I have my Gus Gus one just because I like how he looks up in the front. And then we have the Coco, we have the Christmas one, and then we have all of like our tumbler cup, like more plastic ware, like on the back side. And then I just opened this cabinet and you can see like more of like the souvenir plastics. I have all of like our blender bottles behind this one. And then this is like the other side of like the Halloween ones that you couldn't really see. I think I did a pretty good job on like organizing. I know it still looks like a lot, like it doesn't look not cluttered. Like it's cluttery, but it looks like an organized clutter mess, if you know what I mean. I'm very proud of what I have accomplished here. It was really nice to again, one, show you guys the collection as well as me organizing and using my time in quarantine to get my house all in order. All right guys, that is all the time that we have for this video. If you enjoyed this particular video, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. If you're new here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button for more videos. Don't forget to turn on your notifications so whenever we upload a video or go live, you get notified. If you haven't checked out our Patreon, don't forget to do so. We always love the support that we get on there. Huge thank you to all of our friends right over here for supporting us on Patreon. Finally, if you're not following us on social media, everything is under It's the Duo with two O's. From Casa del Duo, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye! I always thought that that was cheese growing up, but it's corn, right? Or is it cheese? Conspiracy theories. It's says, "My happy place is with you," with Mickey and Mickey, Mickey and Mickey? The first one being the Disneyland Virgin. Like a virgin. And then started the Been There series. Pin drop. What the f? The Andes boot cup that we got at Disneyland. And what's really cool is on the. So again, in like his the mayor. So it says on the back, Trader Sam's. If you enjoyed this video, don't forgive. I can never say don't forgive it. I say don't forgive it, give it. Give it away now. If you enjoyed this video, don't forgive it to give. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget. Don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. Yes, I did. If you're not following us on, no, that's not, no. I forgot to say subscribe. Don't forget, if you're new here, to hit the subscribe button so you can, I don't even know what. Finally, if you're not following, Ashley from Casa del Duo, signing off. No, why do I say signing off all the time? Ashley from Casa del Duo, see you guys in the next.
Starbucks did discontinue the Been There series, but then started the Been There series. What?